Welcome back to Suffolk Insider, brought to you by Studio 73 in the Department of Communications, Journalism, and Media. I'm Hunter Berube.
And I'm Grace MacDonald. Let's begin with the latest headlines from the Suffolk Journal. It's official. The SGA election results are in. For more, here's Will Woodring in this week's Writer's Corner segment.
Thanks, Grace. I'm Will Woodring, staff writer of the Suffolk Journal, and welcome to Writer's Corner. The results for the spring 2021 SGA elections are in. Angela El-Jazar has won the presidency with 37% of the vote. Class Senator Marissa Kearney came in second with 34.5%, while Residence Life Senator at-large Logan Casey had 25%. El-Jazar is a sophomore economics major with a minor in business law and ethics. She was a class of 2023 senator her freshman year and has served on SGA's finance, student affairs, and awards committees. El-Jazar says that she will organize an SGA committee dedicated to listening to students and start a mental health initiative on campus. In uncontested races, current class of 2022 Senator Stephen Ricola has won the vice presidency. Class of 2023 Senator Tara Maltese won secretary, and class of 2023 Senator Evan Weston won treasurer. The winners in the class senator races are as follows. Senators elected for the class of 2024 are Natalie Lemus, Stephen Merrick Jr., Antonio Nunziata, Megan Coleman, and Bryson Boderelt. Senators elected for the class of 2023 are Ana Luisa Bernandez, J.D. Conti, Brian Lee, and Giovanni Suarez. Senators for the class of 2022 are Melissa Contover, Christina Buchanan, and Jenna R. Zempatella. The diversity senator at large is Samantha Garcia. The senator at large for the School of Art and Design is Mason Sawyer Lafferty. Other senator positions for SGA are currently pending as write-in ballots are counted. Congratulations to all the elected students. I'm Will Woodring from Writer's Corner. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Will. Now it's time for the COVID watch. Suffolk saw a total of 11 new cases the week of February 15th. The total number now is 83 since students returned to campus.
New mask precautions are being encouraged by science and health officials. New variants of the virus have been said to originate in countries like the United Kingdom, South Africa, and Brazil. The first cases of the variant in the U.S. were reported earlier this year. For the latest on COVID, visit the Suffolk Journal website.
Sports are back at Suffolk. After almost a year since the last official sporting event, the wait is finally over. A return to play was announced for winter sports in a press release on February 16th from Suffolk Athletics. The Commonwealth Coast Conference, CCC, originally canceled the men and women's hockey and basketball seasons due to COVID-19. But Rams will be back on the hard court and the ice very soon.
Suffolk women's hockey coach Taylor Wasilk was unable to play in the National Women's Hockey League playoffs after several players tested positive for COVID-19. All games were canceled, and because of it, it cost the league an anticipated increase in visibility.
Need a new song to add to your playlist? Paige D'Ambrosio is in the studio and has got us covered. Here's Straight to Streaming with WSFR.
Thanks, Hunter. Hey everyone, welcome back to Straight to Streaming with WSFR. I'm your host, Paige D'Ambrosio from Get Stupid with Paige, and I'm here to tell you what should be on your streaming radar. So let's get right into it with this month's viral chart toppers. If you tuned into Straight to Streaming last time, you would remember we gave huge props to Olivia Rodrigo's driver's license. And unsurprisingly, it has continued to remain at the top of the charts. So for this episode of Straight to Streaming, we're taking a look at songs that have gone viral across the globe. Starting off with quite the surprise, we have a trap remix of the sea shanty, Wellerman. Yes, I can't believe I just said that either. Wellerman, sung by Nathan Evans, a German sea shanty writer who got his start on none other than popular app TikTok. To put it simply, if you like Irish folk music and wish you were a pirate whose boat had bottle service, you'll definitely want to give the Wellerman remix a listen. Up next, we have Sugar Crash, a techno song described to be inspired by early 2000 internet music. Its sound is comparative to a 100 Gex song with its hyper-pop and electronic auto-tuned elements that its creator, Eli Otto, claims to give Sugar Crash a nostalgic feel. It's an infectious sound that, for a minute-long song, knows exactly how to get itself stuck in your head. Coming in at third on the viral charts, we finally have a normal-sounding song. And no offense to trap sea shanties and electronic music, as I can't say I didn't give them both a second listen, it's still nice to hear a song that sounds like, well, a song. Heartbreak Anniversary by Givian was written with the goal of making heartbreak sound beautiful, and that it did. With alternative R&B inspiration and Giveon's deep singing voice, Heartbreak Anniversary is best and easily described as being gorgeous. Now for something a little different. I wanted to use this segment where I usually do a release radar to do a rising artist radar in the rap, alternative, and pop genres. Getting started with rap, someone rising up in the ranks is 21-year-old artist Flo Milli. Flo Milli is often compared to popular female rap artists like Rico Nasty, City Girls, and Tay Money. After getting her start in 2019 with her viral singles, Be Flow Mix and In the Party, she released her first mixtape album, Ho, Why Is You Here? From then, she's only been gaining traction in the rap industry, so keep your eye out for more fresh, unapologetically feminine, in-your-face music from Flo Milli. Now, not to toot my own horn, but in the alternative genre, we have an artist who I have been obsessed with since their first album released in 2018, that artist being Dayglo. Dayglo is the definition of bedroom indie pop, with his groovy and upbeat style taking inspiration from artists like Tame Impala and the Doobie Brothers. This is the definition of feel-good music. Dayglo has been steadily rising in the popularity since their first album, Fuzzy Brain. He's one of those artists where a new song comes out and there's no way it could be better than the last, but it somehow always is. Finally, an up-and-coming artist in the pop industry is Tate McRae. Funnily enough, Tate McRae got her start as a dancer on the beloved show So You Think You Can Dance. Tate's voice is comparative to a popular singer Camila Cabello, but her sound is more adjacent with artists like Olivia Rodrigo, Madison Beer, and Bea Miller. McRae describes her sound as being pop alternative with a major focus on lyrics and meaning. Her first EP, All the Things I Never Said, just came out last year, and reviews claim her to be one of pop's brightest young hopes. If you like what you heard today, check out all these artists on the rise and more new music over at WSFR. Now, per usual, finishing up the episode with Straight to Streaming with my favorite segment, What's in My Playlist. But I actually wanted to dedicate this segment and episode to the duo that changed music, Daft Punk. Daft Punk recently announced their breakup, and fans across the world are saddened but grateful that we got to experience them in their music, with iconic songs like Around the World, One More Time, Harder, Better, Faster, Stronger, and Get Lucky, Daft Punk has dominated the electronic music scene for 28 years. I have been and will always be a fan of Daft Punk and hope you raise a glass and celebrate with them in the best and safest way possible this weekend. To the iconic DJs behind the mask, thank you. And a huge thanks to all of you for tuning in to this month's episode of Suffolk Insider's Straight to Streaming. I hope you enjoyed, because that's all I have for today. Stay safe and rock on, everyone.
Thank you, Paige. Rest in peace, Daft Punk. But in some good news, Suffolk Supers sending messages of love this Valentine's Day. Suffolk University peer health educators shared self-love messages with students as a way to remind them to take care of themselves, especially during these times of isolation and uncertainty.
And that is all the news headlines that we have for you today. Thank you for watching. For more articles, be sure to visit the Suffolk Journal website.
And for more content from the Studio 73, check out the YouTube channel and Facebook page, where you can find our recent Suffolk in the City student news packages. I'm Hunter Berube.
And I'm Grace MacDonald. See you next time.